Alright, so essentially what happened last time is you guys traveled through the forest. Random girl runs at you, screaming. She has a girl with her. So, girl with her is not as she is something with no eyes. You get back, girl runs off the forest. You guys defeat said creepy creature. And then shields and sends off kind of like a burst, and Pi goes unconscious. It was Pi that went unconscious. Yeah. Otherwise, the rest took a kind of significant blow from it, but nothing that, you know, completely knocked you off your feet or anything else. What else happened on the session? Right, earlier, you had come across a man that's guarding her. You all had a dream about her bringing down mountains around her with some kind of lightning. Lightning was her magic user that you had fought a couple days before. You also saw the man that was defending her surrounded by dead kind of creatures, and he was severely wounded. When you chased after her to warn her, they essentially gave you the message of, look, we appreciate the concern, but if we can't handle what we're fighting, you just hell can. And that was pretty much everything that kind of happened in the last sessions. So you guys are hanging out kind of outside of this town by a bit. And that's where we are at right now.
I guess Pi is unconscious next to me. So I'm gonna try and stabilize him. My character's not very good at healing, so I don't know.
Yeah, do you have medicine by any chance?
No.
Okay, then in that case, just give me a wisdom check.
Oh, that's just as bad. I got, no, seriously, I got 3!
Alright. Yeah, to your knowledge, you might be dead.
No! Well, I guess I'll just shake him now. No! Wake up!
His lifeless body flops. I'll
notice he's struggling a little bit and kind of coming over to see if if it can help in any way.
Okay. If you have medicine, you can roll it. Otherwise, you can roll wisdom.
And I got it.
Nice.
Oh, shit.
So, can you tell that he is not dead?
He is just unconscious. He is already stabilized. He's not bleeding out or anything. There's no risk of dying. He probably just needs some time to sneak it off.
No, I'm shaking.
And not get tossed around.
Did we find the girl that ran away?
Nope, she's in the forest somewhere.
Chief is chasing after.
Some dog chased them or something.
Yeah, I sent Chief after.
Yeah, Chief is chasing. Yeah.
With orders to kill.
That's how I interpreted that. Chief's currently eating. Your fearless leader slash fighter man is unconscious. The rest of you are standing around. You are a ways out of the village. What would you guys like to do? You're just attacked by an undead creature. Girl ran off the forest.
I'm going to throw out there that we kind of set up and get some rest and kind of regain ourselves after the whole deal.
I want to look at this creature lady that did or did she like explode or like what happened to her body?
Exploded.
She's still in there, just all dead and not dead.
She was on fire, she was falling apart, and then her head exploded.
Yeah, I know, I was there. That's why I want to...
Is she still on fire? No, she's like smoldering. I can't speak to her at this point. Smashed up pretty bad. But, yeah, not a flaming pile or anything else.
I want to look at this book and inspect it. Does it, like, made of, like, flesh? Does she bleed? Like, what the hell, man? Like, I saw that shit, so...
She kind of give me a wisdom or intelligence, whichever's better.
Oh, yeah, intelligence. Not by much. Oh, 9.
All right. She looks like a person. Just a person that now has no head and no eyes. One thing that you will notice, though, is that her open wounds are not bleeding like an all person's would. They're kind of congealed and this kind of black ichor almost is seeding out of them.
I think we should burn the body, guys. Finish this one off just in case.
I'm game.
I'll go gather some firewood.
I'm gonna try to take some of that black ichor, Alex, and put it in a vial. And if I recall, that was on Pi's leg as well.
Yeah.
So I just want to see if there's any, like, evidence of kind of like a snake bite-ish thing, where it's, like, in the leg, or if it was just kind of covering the surface.
Sure. Give me, wisdom.
Oh, yeah, is Pi a zombie now?
Wisdom or what, sorry?
Wisdom or medicine, if you have it.
Wisdom. 21.
Well, you were right. Cursed, so you know.
Yeah, probably a little bit of it got in the wound, but that's not the biggest concern that you see. The biggest thing is that the flesh around where there are puncture marks looks like it's rotted a little bit. It looks like it's a kind of a festering disease.
Perfect.
Perfect. Chop his leg.
And remind me on 5e mechanics, pretty much... Unless you have magical healing, he needs to heal naturally, correct?
More or less, yeah.
I will try to clean the wound with some water and, like, pus out any of the black stuff that I can.
Okay.
Put that in a vial, and then I'll keep cleaning it. And then when Scott comes back from getting wood, I will... suggest that we go try to find this lady while we wait for Pi to regain consciousness.
Are you just using water from your personal water skin? Do you guys have some other type of water?
Personal.
So you clean up the wound a little bit. Getting out. How long do you want to sit here before you try and pursue water?
I'd do that for the dog is 5 minutes. After. Like five minutes. This is a quick clean. Because I noticed it, and then I'll run off, because I expect that she's probably going to die if I don't chase her soon.
Okay.
And it would only take about 5 minutes to collect a decent amount of firewood anyways. So
5 pass, wound cleaned, firewood gathered and placed upon body. You're running off?
Yeah, I'll ask Almagar to come with me, because I assume he's the tracker.
Sure.
Yeah, see, cool. this is where it differs. I'm actually the better tracker than he is.
Well, it can come.
I'm wiser and she's more intelligent.
Well,
yeah.
With all your stuff.
I mean...
It's your call. I don't mind staying with the cart either, but...
Or you both can go, and I'll stay here with the cart.
Last time that didn't work out so well. So...
Alright.
I'll stay with the cart.
You guys hear Chief barking, and then...
Oh, well, I'll just start heading towards Chief's.
I'll stay with the cart, go.
Okay.
And with that, I'll turn and just use my tinderbox to start lighting the fire on the hag.
And someone's going to have to burn Pi's body over if he tries to.
I'm already poking him. I'm like, someone's got to stay with the body. Dead yet. No.
All right, so the two of you run off into the woods towards the barking of Chief. You guys run towards the barking. Before you arrive at the barking, barking becomes a yelp and then silence.
TPK!
You arrive...
I stay about 10 feet behind Almagar.
And I'm betting that Maple heard this as well, seeing as how she heard the barking.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, maybe you didn't hear this as well.
But there's just a dog.
I mean, she already stabbed it on her own.
Right? I know, right?
Just sort of boot it.
Okay, so the two of you arrive, one of you a good 10 feet behind the other. you arrive at the edge of a clearing, and in this clearing is a small... At one point, a large tower resided here, but it's been hewn down to almost a base, where you can see where a door would have been to enter the tower is now just kind of an open and entryway almost, and then right above that doorway, it's essentially just completely destroyed. So it's, you know, maybe 6-7 feet off the ground, and that's about it. Parts of it are crumbled more than that, though, and you can see kind of on the inside, all it appears is wild growth on the inside of this tower, not a whole lot past that. However, in front of the tower, you can see what appears to be a fresh blood stain, and a woman lying on the ground at the base of said blood stain. Beside her is the unconscious chief.
Wait, she's not unconscious?
Well, she's on the ground. She appears to be unconscious, yeah.
Oh, okay.
The difference is a big blood stain carrying down the wall from her, but not from the dog.
Well, I guess I'll get my weapon and whatnot at the ready.
Okay.
Can I do some like futuristic crime scene situation to see how the girl was attacked?
Do you have that?
I'm highly intelligent, and I use a ranged weapon.
You can
use tell if she was shot from a distance or something?
You can use investigate for this, yeah. If you have it, if not, intelligence.
Sweet. Only 12.
Well, luckily it's not too far, far-fetched. Looks like her head.
I just want to tell if her back's against the wall, or if she got like shot from a disc or something.
No, it looks like her head bashed against the wall several times.
Oh.
darn it! I'll tell him that she's on her. We might want to get out of here.
Kind of go off to the side instead of going like 10 feet close, kind of to around. See if maybe I can see if they're behind the wall or as a rule different skin.
Sure. Alright, it appears that the inside of the wall is on that side is here. You've gotten a pretty good whole interior of the tower there. Yeah, you don't see anybody like around the corner or anything. So, you can success, Chief, and when you, you'll notice that there's a lot of potentially from biting someone.
Oh, okay.
Trailing from Chief is a... dense pattern of blood going inside the tower.
I'll point...
It appears like it's... Yeah, sorry, go ahead.
Oh, I said I'll point that out to Antimatus there.
Okay.
Hmm.
Well, you might as well check her heartbeat. I whisper as loudly as I can with it.
Yeah, I'll take a look at her while I'm at, like, there.
Okay.
Yeah.
Give me either a wisdom or intelligence or medicine if you have. Yeah.
There's blood.
There's blood. Whatever. She's like, hit me. Oh, she's got honor.
So, yeah, I'll pick Chief up, carry him back to Animus, and then ask if maybe we shouldn't come back and take a look inside this tower. Come on.
I'm fine. She's dead. Oh, we can go.
As far as I can tell, but I'm not.
There was a lot of blood.
There was blood, and her head looked pretty smashed, so I bet.
Judging by Al Kamagar's lack of confidence, I will hide and sneak up to the woman and see if I can discern anything more concrete.
Okay. Alright, you want to give me a stealth check?
7.
Alright.
I find the light lunar coming, you know, the moon shining through, and I step right in there and make my way up.
Decide to hide directly in one of the moon's light shafts, yes.
Yeah.
It's dark outside, so hey. Alright, yeah, you move up there, you can see that head is definitely pretty bashed in.
Scotticus, where'd you go? Where did everybody go?
So, that's a 20 for wisdom.
Alright. She is still alive. Barely. Very, very barely. It was difficult to find a life pulse in her, but it is there.
I'll wait for Almagar to come pick her up, and while he's approaching, I'll attempt to snipe her if she is not already stabilized.
Can you give me another wisdom?
19.
She looks like she's a lot of blood, but you're able to do support her in the immediate. Obviously she's not this, but yeah, she's stable.
Great gorgeous, I'll tell him to pick her up and chief, and let's go.
I'll grab her by the hair and
drag her along. So you pick her up, you pick up chief, head back to the cart.
Mm-hmm. Taking care not to like slam him into trees and branches and whatnot.
But yeah, there's the rest. She backed her head a few more times. I told you she was dead. I saw her alive like a minute ago. I told you she was dead.
I'll linger at the clearing and wait for Almagar to go a little distance and then see if anything comes following us out of the tower, and then I'll just follow up again 10 feet from Almagar.
Wait a few moments. Nothing appears to lead the tower towards.
Okay, then I'll follow and hide. I'll go a bit slower, but I'm sure he's not running through the forest, but carrying people. Yeah.
Alright, do you want our stealth?
12.
So you're going to creep along in the shadows. Okay. So before long, you both arrive in the cart. In this time period, you can have one hit point back. You're awake again.
I almost stab you with the spear.
Okay, what happened?
I'm dead!
I'm alive!
Alright, so you both see, you see Almagar come to the trees. He's carrying the young woman over. Looks like she has some head on. And in his other arm is Chief.
Well, I'll do the take. I'll look at Pi and be like, and then just put my spear away and rush over to Almagar.
And I'll crawl over to Joe.
Joe.
Wipe the blood off his face. Cry in his arms.
I'll hand Chief to Maple and then put the girl down near the cart or near everyone else to you.
Jojo was unconscious as well, correct?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so he also slowly opens his eyes as you drag him. He's also got one hit point. He's conscious.
Is it buddy?
Can I tell that the girl is stable? Other than bashed and bloodied by looking at her?
By just looking at her? Give me a medicine. Or...
She's dead. I'm just not done with her yet.
She's 22.
22, yeah.
Yeah, okay. She's definitely stable. She's alive, but...
Do we have a fire going yet, other than the egg?
Other than the egg, no. The egg slowly kind of crafting away and burning.
So I don't really want to build a fire on top of her and then put my food over it.
Oh, are we going to camp right here? Is that the plan?
Except we need to rest, right? There's some...
Yeah.
with all wounded, I think that... Do so?
I'm weakly hacking away at the hag with my sword.
God, bitch.
Die. So I'll start a cooking fire or a cooking slash keep warm fire away from the egg, but, you know.
Yeah, she can kind of be off at the... Yeah. End area. I'm gonna have a look over at Chief and see if I can discern his what his problem is, if
something else has happened to him.
All right, you got a single beast done.
Or I can just roll my dice.
Okay, yeah, he's just unconscious. He's not in terrible shape, but it looks like somebody. Somebody hit him over the head pretty hard. He's got, you know, kind of a swollen section of his skull, but, you know, nothing busted in or anything else, so that's good.
Seems a little more retarded than usual. But...
That's why he's only a sled dog.
Off the sides. But in all seriousness, just like punky in his mouth still. This is probably the source of the blood.
Ew.
I'll pull it out. I want to see, does it look like the flesh of... Does this look like a different type of meatiness?
This looks a little more lifelike. The blood is normal blood, so you'd imagine this came out of a person. And in the hunk, there's also kind of a black piece of cloth attached to it.
Does,
like he took a chunk out of somebody.
Does the cloth match up to the girl at all? As I was over?
She looks like in pretty simple farmer's clothes, whereas this looks like probably like a black heavy robe of some kind.
But because my character's slightly paranoid about the last encounter I had in the woods. Does it seem reminiscent to me of the man in the woods when I stabbed Chief that one time? Of something that he wore?
Not quite, no.
No? Okay.
Yeah, I did not get that one. I wore some pretty decent material. This is not his fire.
Okay. Well, that makes me feel a little better. I'll point to the... So I'll be like, Chief took out something else. This isn't like the hag, guys. Did you guys encounter anything when you picked them up?
We came across, they were both Chief and the girl by some old ruins, not much left of the tower. And yeah, the blood trail led into the trail, the tower. So something we may want to check into.
I don't feel good.
Well,
my leg really hurts.
We'll let Pythagoras take this one.
No!
No! Yeah, you and Chief got hurt.
It hurts.
So, secondary fire set up by you, Almagar. I'm going to assume you're a competent barbarian. You don't burn down the forest till you set it up. So, however, you guys are setting up these fires directly on the road, right? Like, you're not trying to do them off in the brush, because the conversation might be a little different if you're trying to set up fires in the brush.
Not necessarily. I mean, how far are we from the town? Like, obviously, that the girls, and the hag, whatever, I don't know how far they'd come.
We said 2 days.
Yeah. Oh, okay. A couple days. I'm just curious when we might, of course, if we go to rest, we might have some more of these zombies come our way, but now I'm just picturing the Walking Dead.
Just gonna sneak up out of nowhere.
But yeah, I don't think, no, we're not going off, like, into the bush or anything, just not right in the middle of the road, obviously, but, you know, off to the side. I assume there's a little bit of space on the side of the road.
Oh yeah, yeah. You can do it slightly off the side of the road, but obviously, like, not in the totally forested area. Cause it's forest, but
I don't know. Though starting a forest fire might be a good thing.
Guys, we should probably talk about this. We're going to a village. We don't know exactly what's going on there. Like, they could have been attacked. The girl could have ran away. the zombie things could have left, the town could be fine, it could be overrun, everyone could be zombies, like, we should probably, before we get there, maybe not bring the cart and, like, do a little bit of recon or something beforehand, figure out some plan of attack.
Hmm, that sounds good.
Yeah, I'd be for that. I know the area around the town pretty well, so I can be a part of that kind of recon party to see if there is anything to be suspicious of, worried about, anything like that before we kind of waltz into another God knows what.
Do we all want to rest up and then send a recon party, or do we want to send someone now while the rest of us rest?
I think we should all rest up first. We got pretty wrecked from the exploding head.
Not to be paranoid, but I have no idea what that thing was and how it resisted a plethora of swords and fire, but I don't really want to camp here.
Yeah, that's
right next to this thing that I don't know what's going to happen, and getting farther from a town full of more of these sounds like a good idea before we rest. We don't have to go far, but I say we do kind of journey a little bit back.
I thought we were already like 2 weeks away. That's why I asked first. I figured that would be...
Oh, yeah, totally. But this thing made it 2 days away, so maybe it has friends. Or maybe it travels in a pack. I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
But I know I need to rest. I'm, like, barely conscious as it is.
I don't mind staying up and keeping watch. Because, I'd be a little paranoid to just let the dogs take care of it, considering they're not feeling great.
Are you going to stay watch, then? Are you moving the camp at all?
I don't know if... to backtrack, I don't know if that would gain us much, unless we were, like, actually going, like, a full day's journey away type thing, but...
I don't think it'll make any difference.
So yeah, rest up. If any hags show up, we'll be sure to
scream really loudly. And run through the forest.
If a hag decides to scream, you'll all be awakened. Or unconscious, I don't know. Darn, maybe you guys are going to stay awake while the rest sleep. Everyone else.
Okay. All things considered, it is a pretty quiet night. Not a whole lot happens. The two of you sitting there, the only thing of note that really occurs is the young woman kind of flutters her eyes open a few times and mutters a few kind of semi-incoherent words, but then soon falls back into a deeper state of unconsciousness again after she does this. This happens 3 or 4 times. And soon enough, you can start to see some light poking through the boughs of the trees up top, above you. It's probably becoming early morning at this point, and more than likely time for the rest of the party to wake on up.
How can we wake everyone up and scare the living shit out of them at the same time?
And put them all back into comas, right.
Let's get the hag of what's left of her and get her on, like, a little, you know?
Cut off her hand and start, like, caressing people's faces with it. Like,
wakey, wakey. I'll just start making some noise around camp, right? Like, kind of packing up and then kind of, you know.
Sure.
Not trying to be quiet. And...
So the rest of you come to later.
Kick everyone. Wake up. Wake up. Time to get up. We're moving.
Some of you a little easier than others, more than likely, but all of you are up and conscious, along with the dogs as well. As you're kind of packing up and getting things ready, the young woman finally opens her eyes as well and kind of looks at all of you and just mutters this.
Oh, I'm the greatest hero in... What? Oh, well, sorry, what was your name?
She kind of half looks at you and says, "Hero, huh? Oh God, it's all coming back to me. Did you save me from that thing?"
I look at everybody. Yeah, I did. Right?
I'll just look at you with the help of Chief here, too.
Of course.
She just looks at you and she says, oh, thank you so much. I thought I was doomed. What was that thing?
A nightmare. I don't know.
It was a nightmare? I was dreaming?
No, I wish it was. I don't know what the hell it was.
Oh, gods. My village. My village. Those men. Oh, gods. Where are we? Oh, I forgot. How stupid have I been? How long have I been asleep? I have to get back to my full. I have to find them all. Those men, they came. Those creatures.
So, wait. What happened?
Sobbing.
Well, how did this all start? What happened?
Our village to the north. But a few, what I believe, days ago, a troop of men in dark robes arrived. We had never met them before. Being the people that we are, we offered them hospitality, and they actually accepted. They stayed in the camp outside, and they ate our food, and although they didn't speak much, they didn't seem like they were bad people until the night came. And when that happened, creatures started showing up, fighting alongside them. They killed anyone who tried to defend us, and the rest of us, they started taking, chaining up, and bringing off into the forest somewhere. Some of us, they even fed to the creatures. I watched so many people be eaten alive.
Do some of these people have... Do some of these people have abilities? Like, magic?
I don't know of what you speak, sir, but no abilities that I can say are unnatural, if that's what you mean. Aside from the fact that they're fighting among these, what I can only say are dead, risen again.
When you ran into the forest, and you came across that the little clearing there.
Oh, is that where you found me? Gotten about that.
Yes, and there was a dog with you. We're just curious what happened, because I think the dog bit somebody or something and it ran off.
Yes, I felt so coward when I ran. They took some of my family, my sister, my brother. They were captured and taken to the forest. So stupidly, when the woman appeared yesterday, I felt a bit of a coward leaving all of you behind, and in that moment I decided that perhaps it'd be best if I tried to actually make something of my time and find my family. So I continued to wander in the forest, and I came across the clearing, and it seemed to almost call to me. I felt as if I needed to be there, and that was where I needed to search. So I went towards the tower, and one of those men in black robes just appeared out from behind the tower wall. And he grabbed my head and just started hitting it. Oh, I didn't even realize what was happening before it was too late. And then the dog, and she looks over at Chief and she says, that one there might have saved my life. Perhaps he would have finished me, but the dog ran up and bit him. The last thing I kind of saw was him hitting the dog over the head and it falling to the ground, but it was enough to make him want to go away. I don't know where he went. I lost consciousness shortly after, but yeah, that's what I remember.
And I wouldn't feel too bad about the running thing, because those creatures have an unnatural ability to do that, to the best of us.
You're kind to say that, sir, but I'll admit, I've never been one of more than a faint heart.
Do I look like I have a faint heart?
She kind of looks at you as if, is that like a trick question? She says, no, sir, you all stand and fought that creature. I could have never done such a thing.
Just so you know, the same thing that made you run made some of us run too, until we, you know, were able to, you know, realize. But it's definitely some unnatural ability they have to do that.
Well,
because because I wasn't scared of them, but all of a sudden I was running to the bush or to the forest as well.
Well, I would not be ashamed, sir. They are quite frightening.
I'm just shaking my head at him.
She looks at the rest of you, so she said, and then says, "If I may ask, what do you plan to do next? I mean, you fought this thing, killed it. That's better than any of the men in our village did. Is there any way I could convince you to please try and help us? We don't have much, but we could probably pay you in some form. We don't have much.
I kind of feel like I might be dying. Can you take a look at this? Can I roll up my pant leg and show her? Is this normal?
I'm dying!
I'm dying!
As you roll up the pant leg, you'll notice that your rest has really helped. The rotty kind of flesh doesn't look like it's so rotty anymore. It just kind of looks like it's blackened around the edges, but has probably tapered off. And she looks at it, says, "That's quite a nasty wound, sir, but if you know how to prepare a suture, I can guarantee that that'll probably help, and it should clear up in maybe a week or so. If you don't know how to, that's something I can do for you."
No, I was just testing you. Yeah, we can help you.
Okay. Well, thank you.
We were heading to your village anyway to look at doing some...
Are the men still around there?
I don't know. Most of the fighting men were killed when I was still there, and then I was able to escape and run. I don't know how many of them they took, if they took the whole village, or if they left some behind. I really don't know.
Did they say where they might be taking them, or anything like that, or...?
Not a word.
How many of these men showed up? Like, how many were posted outside in that camp of theirs? Do you know?
There had to be at least 10 of them. But when the creatures came, I would say there was another 10 upon that.
Well, we faced these guys before, and none of them are alive, so...
Well, that is good to hear. Perhaps you'll have a chance, then.
Yeah, I took 8 on by myself once. It was quite the spectacle.
My, you are quite the hero.
And Maple here, a moonlit battle on a hill for 48 days. No sleep, no food.
And all the while, Alberger was running through the forest screaming.
She kind of says, "Oh, very, very impressive."
I'd like to roll insight to see if she even believes me.
Yeah, go ahead.
Oh, shit. Oh, that's senseless.
Insight, where is it?
She's quite sure you are full
22.
Of shit.
22. Oh, yeah. You're pretty sure that she, while she believed that you hate men, a 48-day thing kind of
Well, not 48 days. I think I meant more like 48 hours. Yeah. Sorry, I'm hurt.
Okay.
All right, so...
That's the moon talking.
Sorry, I'm dying. I get a little confused sometimes.
You bitch.
Alright, so where the fuck should we start? Sorry. Is there an easier way to get into your village? Like a roundabout way so no one can see us? Another path, another route?
It's a fairly open village. It's not quite large. We don't have walls or anything of that kind. All I'd say is that if you wanted to catch the surprise on them, to the east around the village, there's a cellar of the building closest to the forest on the east. If you go to that cellar, there's stairs that lead back up into the house. You could, I guess, bust out the front door of a house. That might be a little unexpected, but otherwise, if you just take in a normal path into the village, you're probably going to be seen almost right away, if they're still leaving there.
Do we want to go find this guy who initially attacked her and hit Chief?
Yes, yes.
Or should we just start heading towards town?
she'll pipe up and say, I truly do feel as if that tower, there's something that they're doing there. I don't know why, I had intuition. I was drawn to it.
I think we should go check out the tower. We know something happened with there. It's better than having to back and come back here.
Yeah, it might be the
at least we're not leaving danger behind us in case there's something.
That's right.
Well, the cart, we'd have to leave the cart here.
Do we want to, like, stash any valuables that are on there? Kind of, like, in the trees or something like that?
I think we've got quite a...
Or you can see behind. I don't know what's on there, so... I don't know what's on there. I haven't been looking at it. Fleshy sacks, that's all I know.
we'll leave the gimpiest, most injured people behind.
I'm gonna keep Chief with the cart. We can tie up the horses to the trees so they won't run off.
Yeah, okay, we'll leave the dogs to guard that shit.
Okay, so both the dogs will stay behind and you'll tie up the horses.
And what are you gonna do, sorry, what was your name?
Oh, she says, my name is Helen.
Helen.
Well, Helen, is she hot?
Yeah, she's pretty attractive. Like, for a village girl, she's not too bad.
A common.
what would you like to, what would you like to do, Helen? Would you like to come with us? And I give her a little wink.
Give me a charisma check.
Oh, no! No!
Don't you have a disadvantage to your charisma?
Yeah! Oh, man.
You're so creepy.
Oh, I rolled a 20 on one of them. God damn it. you son of a bitch. So 7.
So while you thought you were really good,
that could have been such a good thought.
Disadvantage for the destruction of a nat 20.
So I give her a wink and then a smile, yeah. But there's like some fucking spinach in my teeth or something.
A little bit of
those iron rations.
While she does quite respond to the wink and smile, clearly your heroic allure still makes her want to come. So she says, well, I wouldn't mind accompanying you if it wouldn't be too much of a burden. If there are any clues to what happened to my family, I would like to be there firsthand.
As long as you're not a fucking hag. Sorry. You're welcome to come along.
I don't believe I'm old enough to be a hag, sir.
Just feeling a little off, sorry.
I wonder if someone shouldn't stay with Helen here at the cart, if we're just going to run into the bush a little ways.
If you'd like, I'd be willing to give you a service of, you know, in I'll be frightened, but if you keep the dogs here with me, I could stay with the cart. I don't know what much I'll do other than scream, but I could at least call for you.
I roll a 15 for insight on her.
Okay. She seems pretty truthful, if not a little terrified. You're pretty confident she's not, you know, hiding anything from you.
Don't worry, Jojo is a well-trained squire, and Chief, well, he bites.
Yes, I saw that. He saved my life.
So, just correct me if I'm wrong, but these men came into your village, and they overran how many of your men?
There were probably at least 15 or so that took up arms against them.
Okay. Perfect.
I'm just going to say, I wonder if Alia should stay as well.
I could do that.
I'll just think.
If they don't leave somebody behind with her.
I'm going to take Almagar to the side for a second. When he says that, I'm gonna whisper in his ear and be like, "I think he might be a ghost. I'm not sure, but I didn't tell anybody because I haven't slept in a long time. But I think he's a ghost."
Would you like to stay instead?
No, I just don't want him to steal our stuff and maybe kill the girl.
But if we bite herself, I'm sure those guys will come back.
Why don't I stay with the cart? My dog's here.
I just want to
see what
all of us going in after this
I can handle the horses. I can protect the girl if anything goes down.
As long as you don't fucking stab my dog.
I'll just pull out my dagger.
Whenever we let the shield maiden alone, the shovel maiden.
Shovel maiden, yeah.
Did we leave her alone that one time and then that... Yeah.
Wait. How old is this girl? How old does she look? Does this look like
she's
a girl that's
like...
gonna die around me? Is she that young?
She looks like she's probably like 18 or 19.
She's good to go.
She's old to death.
Okay.
Yeah, she's good to go.
Haven't had a lot of luck with kids in this one, okay? Leave me alone.
Just don't rape this one.
We need to
see it.
Yeah, I don't know.
I'll volunteer. Go in. I don't care either way.
Well, it's all not right, very heroic me to stay behind.
So Maple, you'll stay at the cart with Helen and the two dogs?
Yes.
Okay. The rest of you will go 2 yards to the tower.
Yeah.
Alright. Okay. Jordan, you're headed to the tower as well.
Hope this doesn't take too long, I'm kind of tired.
I'll walk with them, yeah. I'll stay behind them.
Alright, so Almagar, you'll lead them in the direction. Okay. Alright, so Almagar leads a few of you into the forest. You only trudge for, not too long, like 5-10 minutes, before you reach a small clearing. Inside clearing, you can see the ruins that he identified. It looks like the base of a tower that's been hewn above, like, 7 feet, crumbling down to the ground in certain areas as well. You can still visibly see a streak of blood that is now more or less dried against the stone, as well as some blood chipped to the grass that goes from kind of a smaller pool of blood into the tower.
All right, I guess we shall... venture in.
How tall is this tower?
Like I said, it's just the base, so it's like 7 feet at max of what's left of it.
So assuming whatever we find is going to be going down.
There's no windows or anything?
No, totally busted otherwise. You can pretty much see right into it, because where the door was and everything else, it's all gone. So you're essentially looking like straight into the tower when you're staring at it. Not many of the walls are high enough that you can't see over. I mean, the heat is like 6-7 feet, whereas most of it's crumbled straight to the ground. And it looks like it's just overgrowth in there.
All right,
let's go plant some traps with our buddies.
Yep, let's check it out.
So I'll kind of walk through the what was supposed to be a doorway and kind of take a look around and see what I see inside.
Okay, is everyone getting close to the tower?
Yeah.
No, I'm staying on the outskirts in the forest. And then I'll get in line sight so I can see them, but...
Okay. Sorry, Pi, you're heading close to it, though?
Yeah.
Okay, and then Alex?
Yeah, I'll approach.
Just to specify, I'll have my crossbow out, Alex, so...
Okay, so you get the doorway, you look in, it just looks like tall grass. You can see the trail of blood that is... by tall grass, I don't mean like super tall, I mean like 1 foot half. You can see the trail of blood kind of through it, and it looks like somebody stepped through it as well, further into the tower area here. So maybe like 10 feet ahead of you, it looks like the blood trail kind of ends. Looking through the doorway, though, you can actually see a little bit better of the inside, but you can make out a little bit better in the daylight versus last night. And while the tower looks ordinary from the outside, inside looks as if the stone has been in some way tempered or painted black. And it just looks like midnight kind of obsidian type color.
You said there's footsteps in the blood trail there? I'll approach and kind of examine the footsteps, see if I can make anything of them, if it was like
one of our party members, or if it was somebody else has been here since we were last.
Okay. Give me a tracking if you have it, or survival, or... Yeah, sorry, survival is what I meant by that, or if not survival, wisdom.
10!
Alright. You're not sure when these footprints occurred by taking a look at them. However, stories everybody told you, nobody has gone into the tower in your party, so likely it's not from any of you guys. But whether it was before or after everything that happened, whether it was in the last couple hours or not, not clear.
I'll take a close look at that black stone kind of thing. And...
Okay. Scott, would you describe yourself as a very religious character?
Oh, you know what?
Do you worship one of the nine gods? You don't have to follow any gods. They're not quite as directly involved in this world as, like, Forgotten Realms stuff, but they're very much like,
You would definitely be following the Onassia, the lawful good, justice, war, honor one.
Yeah. Yeah, Onassia. Yeah.
What about nature?
Really? That doesn't sound like me.
Nature.
He was brought up with...
I'm not very lawful, that's for sure.
No, but that's the god alignment, not yours.
Yeah.
Either that or there's Aaron for nature.
I'm quite sure I'd be doing the same god as you. Back in those days, family following different god, no.
Well, let's say that you don't necessarily have to determine who you follow right now, but I'm going to say you know maybe enough, like, rudimentary knowledge about it to identify that as you look at this wall, you can actually see an engraving, a very ancient engraving, hard to make out as this one's kind of been, you know, smoothed over time. It's near disappeared, but you're able to see an image depicting a god named... Rink.
That's my god.
Yeah, Rink.
Such a dink.
The god of luck.
Yeah. You're not very lucky.
That's why I pray to him.
I was gonna say you need to get on that.
Well, I'll just say, point out to everyone that's
what you see initially, right? So you see Rink there, the god of luck, and it's all very nice. As you kind of follow the image on the wall, you notice it goes... Rink has something extending from him. In fact, it's from his neck. And then you realize it's actually a corded arm that's grasping Rink's neck. And as you observe this, you can see his eyes are kind of bulging a little bit more. You thought he was maybe happy at first. Yeah, not so much. This arm has it by the neck. He actually looks afraid. And the arm goes up to this kind of large, and by large, I don't mean like physically large, but like just all I can describe is a dominating female figure. But it's so worn down and part of the wall is broken there, you can't tell exactly who it is. But you could probably guess it's one of the other female gods.
Interesting. Yeah, I'll point that out to the rest of the party.
Can I identify this woman that's strangling Rink?
Yeah, give me a 20 wisdom, or I don't believe religion is a thing, but if it is, feel free to do that as well.
Yeah, I got
it. It is a thing, yes.
Oh, it is? Okay, if you got religion, then roll that.
19.
Yeah, you're pretty positive that it's the goddess Fikir, and she's the goddess people talk about when they want to freak out their children to make them not do bad stuff. She is very, very, very evil.
Destruction, not
a great goddess at all. And she's kind of the one that is in charge of making sure the world ends one day.
Oh.
You must be related to...
I think I should worship her. No. In-game.
So, does this look like an altar or something?
No, it doesn't appear to be. It's just kind of an engraving in the wall. Looks like maybe it's something that would be in place of a tapestry. You know, it's more of a permanent fixture. But, yeah, no altar or anything else.
There's nothing else on the wall besides this?
If there ever was, it looks like the pieces that would have continued are smashed away. And when whatever happened, just to make this tower fall.
speak enemy and enter.
However, walking over to this wall, all of you have kind of stepped through the middle of this thing to get to the wall, which is where the blood trail kind of ended. And there's a pretty nondiscreet patch where grass has not grown where the blood trail ends. It looks like just a big hunk of dirt to you. But, yeah, it's pretty obvious that that's not natural.
Oh, well, nothing more here. Let's go back.
Can I investigate or something? I don't know.
Yes, you can. Yeah, 100%. Go for it.
Is this magical? Or I guess I wouldn't know that, eh? Natural 20.
You explode!
Your hair turns blonde.
Gain a charisma point. Yeah, okay, so you take a look at this thing and you're like, chumps. It's meant to be like a secret door, like a trap door that is supposed to be semi-hidden underneath dirt, but somebody's done a really shitty job of recovering it.
Must have been bitten by a dog or something.
And you can see the latch. And they probably could imagine you just need to pull, and it should open right up.
All right, well, dust it off and then pull it up and show everybody.
All right. Sure, you pull up on it. This wooden kind of plank pulls out. A little bit of dirt falls down into a very dark hole. The hole has a ladder descending.
But, oh, this looks inviting.
Otherwise,
shall we?
Can we see the bottom?
Can you see the bottom? No.
Yeah.
And is Antimea still hiding in the trees?
I'll light up my hooded lantern.
Okay.
And cover it up so it's not too bright. Sure. Alright, shall we?
We shall.
Alright. So I'll go in first.
He's going first.
Yeah. I'll go in right behind Pythagoras.
And I'll follow.
Okay. And Antimaeus, you'll just see these guys lift up some panel on the ground and they all start climbing into the ground. are you going to still remain in the forest for the time being?
Yeah.
Alright. So the three of you descend. By his lantern, it provides you enough light, you know, kind of make out the rungs of the ladder when you're in the dark. But one thing you're going to note is that whatever you're climbing down into must be pretty big, because even with that lantern at your side, climbing down a few rungs, you cannot see the bottom nor the walls of whatever you're in right now.
Oh, I'm going to take out a ball bearing and just toss it down below me until I hear something.
Okay. A few moments pass, and then you hear a clatter at the bottom, so it definitely does have some kind of solid base. You've done this a few times, so by your estimate, it's probably at least 100 to maybe 150 feet down.
So get ready for a climb, fellas. About 100 feet down. Watch out for the ghost.
Alex?
Yep.
I'll wait about 5 minutes to be specific. So.
Okay. Alright, so you guys continue on down. Rung by rung. Surprisingly, this ladder is pretty sturdy. Occasionally, one of the rungs creaks and cracks, but nothing beneath you.
Is it wood?
You continue to climb for a few minutes down the ladder. You still can't quite see a whole lot. I'm assuming the three of you will continue.
Yep. The ladder is wood?
It is, yeah.
Okay.
Yes, and it must be fairly recently placed here, because, again, for how ruined everything else is, this is in pretty good condition.
Is it, like, I don't know, damp in here, or is there, like, a specific smell or anything that I'd make note of?
Oddly enough, it's actually, for going underground, it's not too dank, so you're not getting the typical molds of wetness or smell, or of wetness or mold that you typically get underground. It's actually quite dry, if anything. But it just smells like stone. Alright, so 5 minutes passes there, Jordan. They have not come back up. What would you like to do?
I'll head over and go on down.
So you head over, you see the ladder descending down, you can see a light from, presumably, Pythagoras' lantern that you saw him light before going in. Alright, and you continue on down.
You can see a light way down there.
Yeah. Alright, a bit more time passes, and you can start to see the floor. It looks like it's a polished stone. So it's
like you're not going into something that is just a natural cave formation or anything else. This was definitely constructed. It is kind of a black stain, just like the walls were outside as well. So you get to the base of the ladder, and you hop up, and you get a little bit of a better idea as to how large this area is. You still can't quite see the walls. You must be near the center or whatever this is. But a few feet away from the base of the ladder, you can see a large basin of some kind of dark liquid.
Are there any like footprints from the blood anywhere?
Yes. In fact, they trail off from the ladder, and there's a couple bloody footprints that walk up to the basin.
Is it just
no footprint, at least from what you can see.
Is it just one set of footprints?
Can I tell if they're the same footprints that I looked at up top?
Yeah, you're pretty confident they are.
Cool. I'll just kind of quietly mention that to the guys. Yeah.
So if I put out my lantern, we'll probably be in pitch black, eh?
You'll likely be very, very pitch black, yeah. If you unhood your lantern, again, you might be able to see a little bit more of the area, but that's obviously your call.
I guess I'll turn to you two and be like, should I maybe unhood this, get a better look at this place?
Yeah.
Alright, just be ready. So, I'm gonna unhood my lantern then.
Before that happens, hang on.
In other words, no, don't do that.
Yeah, cool. Let's shine some light on this room.
Wow, that was quite suspenseful.
And suspicious.
Yeah, sorry, Alex is just one of the evil, like, guy in my room, so he's to discuss when he's going to kill you, how he's
going to discuss. This is the right dark room.
Yeah.
This is the one where I sacrifice. Yeah, okay.
Okay, so in all seriousness, you kind of unhood the lantern so it's got a little more just your omnidirectional light coming out of it. And it lights the room. Do it. So you are in a very, very large circular room. The ladder is near center, offset just a little bit, because what it appears to be is the dead center of this big circular room. Oh my god, it's huge. Is this big basin. The basin is probably at least 5 feet tall and 2x2 across. Otherwise, this room is pretty unremarkable as far as contents. If you were to put a compass in here, north, south, east, west, there is what I could roughly call a door at each of those points. There are four doors. However, these doors more so look like just bars than they do actual, like, a door that you would open. They're more like almost prison cell bars than anything else. Looking down on the floor, you can see a huge engraving around this basin. Like, it's massive. You wouldn't notice it until this light was shone directly on it. It takes up almost the entirety of the circular room, and what it appears to be is the engraving of a huge sun.
Sorry, where is this?
It's on the floor.
On the floor.
Yeah. And this room is like at least like 80 feet by 80 feet in diameter. So this sun is entirely massive.
So we probably can't make out much beyond these cell-like doors?
Correct. Okay. Yeah, it looks like they might lead to a room or a hall of some kind.
But it's pretty dark beyond the bars.
And you said there was a basin?
There is, yeah. Dead center of the room, about 5 feet tall and 2 feet across. There are some small steps up to it, so you could walk up those to, you know, look directly in it.
I would like to do that.
So you walk up near where the bloody footprints walked up, and you look into it. The basin appears to be more or less completely full with a dark, murky liquid. Even as you shine the light on it, you see this kind of deep red hue.
Amagar, taste this.
Yeah. No, I'm good.
I.
So as a quick aside, because you guys for a bit, Maple, I am gonna say that like for them being gone to just go check on stuff, they've been gone for probably more time than you would have originally expected. Just in case that's any bearing on what you're doing.
Well.
We want to go take a look. We want to go find this guy.
What time of day now are we looking at? Roughly.
Still quite early morning.
Early morning. You know, whatever. I still have the dogs with me. I'm right here where we are. I'm gonna set up another little campfire, and I'm gonna if they're taking a while, I'm gonna set around some of my one trap, but I'm gonna put it. Not on the trail that they're coming from, but like behind. Just to be specific, right. Put it behind us the way we just came.
Oh my God, losing a foot.
We were victorious. Oh my God. Maple strikes again. What's your alignment to kill me?
Hey, it's not my fault you walked into it.
I have all right. People should know, yeah.
So in that case, yeah, you set up another fire, you put your hunting trap down, not in the direction of the party, and you kind of fortify in a little bit. Okay,
Alex, just for the sake of it, yep. I'm not... I guess you could say I'm kind of meditating, just for the sake of I'm out in the woods, you know, I'll just stare off into the fire. But I'm not performing any of my rituals or anything, but just focusing on that, because now would be the time that I'd be kind of doing that sort of stuff.
So, hi, you are in the space, you are upon steps, just looking down into a...
I jump in! Whee! I'll dip the tip of my blade into it and see if it gets like kind of if it's sticky or whatever.
Okay. Yeah, you dip your blade into it. Seeing how your blade makes it look a little more familiar. It's pretty positive this thing's full of blood.
Shit! Oh my God, you guys, this shit is full of blood. It's full of fucking blood.
I mean, when you go through, there's blood. What?
No.
You said the shit's full of blood.
No, not my shit. Not my shit, the basin.
Well, a little bit of both, right?
Well, I've been feeling pretty sick. Alright, let's just split up. So I'll go north, you go east, and then Alias can go west.
And one of us goes into the pool of blood.
Antimaeus, if he shows up. Well, what should we do? Should we...
Just hope for the best. How far down this rabbit hole do we want to go?
Yeah. Well, I guess we could follow the tracks? Or, no, they went into the basin, didn't they?
And again, I remember, you know, like, Jordan's thing, you know, do we really know what side we're on yet? Or, like, we haven't heard their side of the story, but...
Well, they summoned a hag, which I really, really don't like anymore.
Mm-hmm. So the credits can be using magic.
I feel like this might be like a necromancy lab or some weird creepy shit like that.
Yeah, my character I don't think really knows much about religion, for sure.
Well, I guess we could pick a direction and hope for the best.
Oh...
Or we could split up. I don't know about that, though. It's
pretty much... don't like splitting up. I mean, there's quite a few of us, I guess. But same thing, even in groups of two, you come across a couple of those credits, it can be pretty
Yeah.
sketchy. I should have stayed behind with the cart. Also, now the guard's like, I just want to go to sleep.
Tracks
into the basin, right? Or were they
just... they went up the steps to the basin, and...
Hold on, well, the guard doesn't want to stop us here.
Yeah, my own.
Where's that to me?
I'm assuming you're going all the way down the ladder, right, Jordan? Or you're just gonna, like, sit up there?
Well, I've been just enjoying their conversations thus far, so I'll finally come down the final couple rungs. And then I'll stay and hide until they find me.
It's late. That you...
Right here.
Prime fist.
23. Nice.
Oh, now that you're hiding from us, this is when you're like super strong.
Just when you need. Well, Pythagoras is looking into the blood and freaking out about it.
I'm gonna look above it to see if I, like, are there shackles or some way that blood ended up here that would be obvious. Ah, yes, good thing you look up the core component of my campaigns. There's a giant spider. No. Sorry. The other guys have probably some nightmares about that, at least I do. Anyways, so, no, there's nothing hanging from, like, a ceiling or anything else. It's just, honestly, this base, no blood. Can we see the ceiling? No. So, if there was, like, a chute where blood poured from, you might not see it. Yeah. In fact, on the construction of this, how far up you can see, you're pretty sure, like, where the ladder entered, probably the ceiling.
Oh, shit.
Like, this whole area is not that hollow.
Cool.
I'm gonna go check one of the gates, I guess. I'll check the one to east, see if it's locked.
Okay, can you give me an investigate check, please?
Investigation! I got 3.
Or 7, actually. No, 8. 5.
At the level to which you're inspecting this thing, so you see. The bars appear to have no keyhole or anything open them, nor any lever to open them. They just appear like prison bars that are in your way, essentially. You will, however, notice that there's holes in the ground that potentially come from. Outside of that, perhaps there is a stone hallway that goes farther than your magic shines.
Can I lift the bars?
Go ahead, give me a strength check. Or athletics.
Gonna be strength. 16.
Acrobatics.
16?
Yeah.
Alright, you heave and hoe to try and lift or make these things do something that they're not supposed to right now. You feel a little bit of, like, give to them, but not enough to raise them.
I don't know, I think these bars might lift if I'll go for it, but I don't know if we want to go down here.
Muscle, do you?
I'll head over to hand. Lend a hand? Yeah, go on.
Come on and hand a lend.
Okay, guys, I'll hold the lantern, you do the heavy stuff.
I'll go help lift as well.
Okay, so the three of you. Alright, each of you give me an athletics if you have it, or a strength. If you don't.
16 on me.
I'm finally feeling fairly barbarish. I have 22.
Ew.
7.
7?
Yeah. I threw out my back the first time, guys.
That's a little part.
My thing. Okay. Sure enough, between the three of you, you'll hear the bar creak, and it's something kind of kicking on the other
side of the bars as you raise them. So it's going like this. Tick, 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 tick.
Bomb run!
Every time you show the tank, it almost feels like it locks into place, so it doesn't feel quite as heavy. But to get the next tank, it's minimal.
So almost we'd be comfortable letting go if we had to?
Maybe.
Okay.
But you did head up to a height where you're able to crouch underneath it if you so choose. Pretty comfortable.
Okay, one,
two.
Do
you want to try and open them up, or?
As long as we can get through, I'm sure.
Well, I mean, cool.
So I'm going to head back to the ladder and take a look up and see if Antimius is decided to join us.
Okay, so you let go then, and it does not fall into the ladder.
Oh, I figured it. Okay, yeah, I would obviously make sure that's...
let go. Just crush his alias.
You guys got this?
Sorry.
It's okay, he's a ghost.
I don't expect it. I'm just going to go back to let her look up, because I'm sure I'll see some daylight at the top there.
Yeah, did we leave the hatch open?
No.
No one pulled it down, so it's assumed open.
That's mass. You hear the gate kind of you start to hear this. And you notice that the...
I pull up my crossbow.
Okay. You notice that the basin is starting to bubble. And then you start to hear...
Chewbacca?
And then a bunch of them all start to happen. And they sound like voices, but indiscernible. Until it almost sounds like there are at least 10 of these voices kind of speaking in chaotic form. As you're walking over there, Almagar, to go find them, you hear this as well. Notice bubbles peeking at the top of this basin as well. Alias and Pythagoras, after a few moments, you can also hear, because it's echoing through this chamber, just...
Is this basin on anything? Like, is it, like, built into the floor? Or
yeah,
is it just,
like, stone built right in the form, yeah.
Oh, shoot.
The voices are coming from the basin?
Yes, they are.
I will,
Up the ladder, up the ladder.
Pull out my sword.
I guess we tripped the security system.
Apparently.
So you start to hear more voices in a few moments after. Tentacles start coming out of this basin. What would you guys like to do?
I want to go home.
I run for the ladder and start climbing.
Okay.
Can,
yeah, that sounds like a good idea to me.
Can me and Ilya see it?
That's where I'm heading.
Alright, so you come around the ladder.
Climb, climb!
Okay, so we've got Antimaeus up first and Almagar up second. Plan is she's both gonna rush behind, so you can get there first.
Pushed each other into the basin.
Push me into the basin.
A new hero monster!
Athletics or acrobatics if you have it. If you don't have it, give me a dexterity check.
Acrobatics would be awesome if you could go through the ladder.
16 for me.
And what did you do? Oh, that was athletics.
And a 10 for dexterity.
Aha!
So right. I made a leap onto the ladder in front of him.
Yeah. You're just like... I'm at the base of the ladder. At the base of the ladder, you're like waiting for these guys to get high enough up so you can start climbing. More tentacles will start to sprout from this basin, and you just hear this eyes, this mound of just flesh and holes and just disgusting. It's essentially like, you know, Pizza the Hut drums.
Yeah.
Made of flesh. That's what it looks like, okay? And it just starts, like, pouring and kind of, like, flooding out of the fountain. And it almost looks like there's several of them coming out of it. And the one big thing you'll notice is some of the tentacles appear to have hands at the end of them, and eyeballs are just scattered throughout it in just, like, no apparent order. But all of them seem to be focusing on you guys as you climb the ladder.
Are they reaching for us?
Yeah. They're attempting, but you guys were quick enough to immediately decide to get the ladder. So you're up high enough where the tentacles are, like, reaching up. But not quite getting to you. This goes on, you guys climb the ladder, you can still hear them. Their moans and wails start to become almost more perturbed. Like, they start becoming a little sharper, and as if they're, like, angry or understanding what's going on and why they can't, you know, do something to you.
And they just want to play?
And they just want to play. So they don't understand what the issue is. And this, like, and then all of a sudden they start letting out these shrieks, just and it just, like, echoes throughout this whole thing. And I need everybody to make a wisdom save, please.
Oh, this is gonna be fun.
They're just gonna swan dive up the ladder.
Wisdom save. I'm glad I'm not there.
15.
13 for me.
18.
Nice. How would you end, Mass?
22.
Nice. Okay.
Starts up the top.
So while the voices kind of pierce their mind for a few moments, you might have to stop on a run of the ladder for a moment or two. You tell yourself not to let go of the ladder.
Keep climbing, keep climbing.
Voices are something you have to get away from, not close to. And then you continue to climb, and the voices start to calm down as you get higher up the ladder. Until you reach the hole in the ceiling that reveals it, and you all get out of it quickly enough. But you can still hear this gibbering from down below echoing.
I'm gonna
close the trap door once we're all out.
I'm gonna light a torch, throw it down there, and then lock up that fucking trap door.
Look for some heavy rocks.
yeah.
Just flame, like, descends the darkness, and it, like, hits something, and you hear the... And then you shut that.
Fuck this shit, let's get out of here.
I'm done. I'm out.
No man in a black gear, we're good. Let's go.
I don't know where this girl's family is.
Just no family down there.
Alright, so you guys heading back to the cart then?
Yep.
Oh, hells yeah.
So you all reapproach the cart. You can see a small fire has been lit by Maple, and she's there meditating while the young girl is just kind of sitting on the cart, dangling her legs. And as she sees all of you, she says, "Oh, you've returned unharmed. Tell me you have good news. Did you find anything?"
Someone want to take this one?
I'm going to go to the cart, and I'm going to go to sleep.
Straight to the cart. I'll throw out that we just found some blood in there. It seems like there's nothing extra there that went on. When
yeah,
their last, and maybe we should continue on.
There were like,
as you still
there were like
shaking in fear.
There were like 12 or so guys there, but I managed to defeat them all. But no sign of your family, unfortunately.
Oh wow! And you did that all uninjured. That's amazing. Oh. No sign of my family, hey?
No.
Did
no.
any of them give you any answers before you slew them?
No, they were trying to kill me. So, yeah, we should go though. Yeah, okay. Like now, actually, we should probably go right now. Yeah.
How good you guys start moving? I'm already.
And I'm going to go over to Maple and whisper in her ear, like, hideous fucking monster, hideous. It was huge. It was monstrous. It was gibbering. We got out of here.
Right.
There was no one. I didn't fight anybody. I'm so scared.
Exhale, I'm like, I want
mommy. What was this girl's name again?
Helen.
Helen.
Helen. Right. I'll help Helen into the cart. I'm assuming she'll need it. And get her situated in there.
I will go grab my hunting trap and put out. I'm not gonna put out the fire. I'm just gonna leave it.
Burn down the ruins.
I don't know. I'm just leaving the fire alone, but I'm gonna go grab my hunting trap.
So you all get packed up and you're gonna just continue on.
Yeah, it's
annoying. Yeah.
All right. So you continue on.
So did nothing else down there?
Nothing.
You guys didn't find anything. You were gone quite a while.
Yeah.
Yeah. No.
Just an altar. It was like this cool thing to the gods. That was about it.
An altar and gods.
Yeah, it was a kind of like a history of Rink and Fygar, whatever the hell her name is, a goddess of destruction, choking him out. It was pretty hot, actually, but...
I think Iris may have been a little distracted. That's why I took so long.
I needed a few minutes.
Okay, well.
It's when those 12 guys came up, you know.
Yeah, she was like super muscular. Guys, can remind me of you a little bit. You know,
someone's
choking.
It's just to get really immersed in this drawing, don't worry.
Anyways.
As you sleep, Helmagar, your dreams are riddled with...
Oh, of course they are. Good thing Amy has headphones on, eh?
Those who heard the gross things, you're gonna notice that strange noises, like in the woods once in a while, make you think that you're hearing it again, and it's like just gone. It's like, God, I must be hallucinating kind of feelings. But you occasionally hear as the wind howls, like kind of over the wind.
Oh my God.
During any of these events, I'll probably look over at some of them and see if they're also reacting, or if it's totally just me. Do I notice other people reacting at the same time, or...?
It seems like, for the most part, it's happening at different intervals for you guys. You're just...
Perfect.
It's more of a paranoia thing than anything else.
Cool.
You guys continue to ride on. Antimaster, are you on your horse, riding behind?
Yeah, I'm moving up.
Anything you guys would like to accomplish over the next couple days while traveling? You're going to the village.
Again, we're probably going to go straight to the village. We'll be probably send someone like to go ahead for we'll go ahead to do recon, but
I'd like
for
to
now, stop like a few hours out, or
we'll want to stop. Definitely.
I'd like to just sit in the back of the cart and kind of like put the pieces of my rapier together and try and find where the pieces are going and all that.
Okay. So you guys will manage to get in to rest. The journey is fairly uneventful. Ilias is the signal to stop. He's pretty confident that you're a few hours out of town at this point.
So, Helena, you got a boyfriend?
Check their
God damn it.
By now. By now she's married to a 40-year-old and have three kids. She's already 19 or 18.
Fuck. Four.
So So are the nice shoes, motherfucker.
And you thought you were so smooth.
She kind of looks at you, like, oddly, and says, sir, while I'm flattered, yes, I am to be betrothed. So yes, you could say I have a boyfriend.
To a selfie.
Are you faithful? No, sorry, I didn't mean that. I didn't mean to say that, sorry.
Is your eyebrow still raises?
Or did I?
Scrape the rapey vibe.
Do you want to help me reassemble my rapier? Okay, so yes. Yes, no. He slides away a few inches from you and just tries to kind of focus on what's going on around. But yes. So after a couple days of travel, you stop a few hours out of town at Alias's signal.
Hit on everything that moves, don't ya?
Did you say something?
Cool, so I'll mention that we're a few hours out of the village, and we should probably stop here while we go ahead and check out what's going on. And then I'll see if you guys want to try and go through the cellar and come out of a house, see if we can see things from the windows, or we just kind of want to go ahead, scout it out, and fling it.
I like the idea of going through the cellars.
What time of day is it?
You'd arrive just before midday.
Yeah, so I thought that we can definitely do that. I know roughly where they'll be located, and see what's going on.
Let's do the cellars, then.
Cool. Helen looks at all of you and says, can I come along? I'd like to see what say the village is.
Of
I think
course.
It might be best if you stay back for a little bit, just in case demons are still there, unless you think you can fight them.
Yeah. Might be safer if you stay with the cart.
Yeah, come retrieve me at least if that all is clear. Of course.
Yeah.
We'll come back for our stuff. You can come with.
Yeah.
I will leave Chief with you. I'll leave Chief with her and the cart.
Don't worry, m'lady, we shall return. And I'll grab her hand and give her a little kiss on it.
Oh, God. She just kind of pales a little bit when that happens.
And then give her the wink and smile.
The rest of us are just shaking our heads. Sorry.
Hey, Pa, you should find out where this guy lives to go take care of him. Check in on him, make sure he's okay.
Help.
Can Antimas will confirm with Alias that we're about 2 hours from the village, is that correct?
Yeah, to my knowledge, estimate, yeah, I'd say about 2 hours, and then we go, like, around, would it add, like, an extra hour, maybe, to the cellar?
Should maybe, like,
20 minutes? Cool.
I'm maybe, it's just because I'm not used to walking so much, but a two-hour distance seems like a lot. Perhaps we could close the gap to maybe like a 30-minute distance so that we're not running for a very long time to try to get to our cart.
We could also do that.
Okay.
This is assuming the path is windy and you can't see 30 minutes straight ahead into the village.
Yeah. you won't get
to or 30 minutes from where they were camping outside the village. We don't want to end up in the black cloak camp either.
Right.
That's a good point. Do you guys remember, did Helen mention which... Let's ask Helen. Where did you say that camp was again? Outside of your town?
It was on the western edge of the town. You should be okay if you're approaching. Yep. So, as we are. So, you get as close as possible without being able to be seen by the village in about 30 minutes. And then you dismount on the same plan as before. I'm assuming you're going to head out to the east a little bit, circle around, and go to the cellars. Is everyone going aside from Chee?
Yes.
Yeah, I'm going. Not sitting this one out.
So you all continue.
I'll whisper to Helen that she can wait a while and then follow if she wants.
You guys are led by aliens in the forest that eventually wraps around. And he leads you to the kind of edge of the forest on the east side of town and to see the cellars that Helen has identified. However, looking into this village as well, you do see a few things. While there are no villagers, there are certainly other things that have replaced them. Things that look like they may have once been villagers shamble around the town, slowly moving from building to building, sometimes just standing and staring vacantly off. And more regal soldier types stand at a few corners of the village as well. However, upon looking at them, you notice that they do not have flesh. They are skeletons, clad in mail with spears.
Do we see
to the next town?
Do we see any survivors at all?
How long do you sit on the outside of the town? Before making a decision to go in or leave?
Well, we probably stay a little bit, definitely make sure.
Yeah, I'm not really good at gauging time, so.
5-10
Half an hour.
About 15 to 20 minutes of sitting on the edge of the town. Not much has changed aside from a few of the kind of things shambling around. Until eventually a man comes walking out of one of the houses, clad in black robes, and dragging behind him a villager of some kind. The guy looks pretty big, he looks beaten, bruised, cut up a bit, and two skeletal soldiers trap him behind him. All move towards the center of the town, and skeletons point spears at the villager, and he falls to his knees, and the man moves up into him, so I'm not sure he has time across the face. That sort of thing, but you can't quite make out what they're saying.
How far away are they from us?
Mm-hmm. A few hundred.
Is there any buildings and stuff in between to, like, sneak and kind of shamble from place to place to get close?
Yep.
Done. Antimaeus get off, and he does that. I'll try to stay in shadows and whatever, but...
Before you go, because I don't know if I see you. I'll probably see you leaving or whatever. I'll grab you and be like, start as many fires as you can.
With that, Antimaeus runs off. Give me one stealth check there for you.
12.
Okay. So you move throughout the shadows from building to building as best you can. You go down a small alleyway between like a tannery and what appears to be some kind of, like, baker shop or something. Some cells to deliver their bread. Until you get to kind of a block in your path where there are a couple of shambling creatures, they don't seem to notice you, but they're just kind of standing out in the alleyway, staring at the walls.
I'll toss a rock in the opposite direction myself.
Seems to work well enough. They turn and look at it, and they kind of limp off towards it very slowly. And give you clear the alleyway. You arrive at an opening that faces the main field of square. You can see the man and the villager. Things have escalated a little bit. He's yelling quite loudly. The rest of you, while Antimaeus is moving on, is there anything you guys would like to be doing?
So there's quite a few buildings in between, like,
yeah, I mean, it's not a big place by any means. There's probably at least like 10 to 12 buildings between you. You can look down the road from where you guys are.
Yes.
You can see the center of village. There's higher ceilings going on, but on either side of the road, there's buildings.
We assume that the cellar only goes to this building that's immediately in front of us.
We'll get you all the way out to one of the buildings in the main area, or wherever that means.
I'll approach the cellar door, see if it's locked or anything, or if we can open it without bringing attention down this way.
Okay.
It does appear to be unlocked, potentially locked as well. And it's like, it looks like they're beaten in it. The doors wouldn't in it. So they couldn't make too much noise to open up.
But it looks they, like they were recently.
Somebody bought in here at some point, yeah.
I'll slowly open the doors anyways. Take a peek inside.
Alright. Looks like a pretty standard cellar, a few crates, a couple barrels down below. Yeah, nothing too ominous in there as the morning light kind of begins.
Okay, so I'll like go in and see if there's like a hallway going out.
Looks like there's actually staircase from the opposite side of the room. So I'm just going to drive right now.
Cool. I will go check out the next door. There's a door at the top?
Yeah. Sure.
I'll check it out.
Wooden door also looks like it was broken this side. But not open.
I will ease it open.
Ease it open on the side of the door. You are looking at the back of the figures. It is kind of semi-fleshy. Looks like it does not turn to face you. Just stares blankly down the way, but you're like a foot or two back.
Semi-fleshy like a villager, like the ones shambling around?
Yeah.
Okay. I will slowly close the door and head to Zellar.
Alright, you head back out the cellar.
Very carefully.
Meet up with everyone.
Yeah. Okay. And I tell them that there is a thing.
Okay. Hey guys, there's a thing.
There's one of them inside.
Oh, no.
Do we go in and try and slay it?
Fire's probably our best option, to be honest. I mean, we've been out here for about 30 minutes, haven't seen it, except for maybe that one that died. But,
Okay, while you guys are debating that, Science Man, as you are looking out the village square, the man in the black robe is pretty viciously asking this villager, where is he? I know he came through here. He would have been young. You know of who I speak. He would have been an older woman. She would be very identifiable. Do not play dumb with me, or I will take you where I've taken the rest, and he's passed me. That's very similar language like this. Lots of threats being thrown around.
Do I identify any... Like, he's wearing black, right? Not gray.
Correct. She is wearing a black robe, no armor is identifiable. It's like a toe robe.
So no sigils, nothing.
That's definitely a sigil. On the black robe there is a large white sun embroidered across his chest.
Do I recognize it from being in the city?
No. No, this is a to you.
How close can I get? Like, they're in the middle of a square or something?
Yeah. Yeah. So, maybe within 20, 25 feet.
Okay. Oh. And how many of the shamblers do I see around the area?
So there's two shamblers kind of walking around, and there's four skeletal guards, plus the two that are behind them.
Right.
Six total.
I will take out my crossbow and take a shot at him, I guess.
Can we see Jordan? Still?
No, you guys are not able to see him at this point.
Okay.
Yeah, you can look down the road directly again what's happening, but he stayed in the shadows well enough that he's not perfectly visible at the moment. He's peeking out from one of the other buildings.
Out of sight, out of mind.
Okay, you take a shot.
Does 24 hit?
So yeah,
does 24
hit? You have advantage on it if you want to double check for a critical.
Yeah, no, I totally did. Okay. That's because my new ability gives me advantage when they haven't gone yet, so. So I'll roll damage.
Okay, and make sure you add sneak food as well.
Alex, for critical, do I add... So, like, I do my weapon damage twice, points, right? So that's 24 points of damage. Yeah, I get no crit if I hit when I'm not known.
Nice.
Wow.
That's crazy. Okay.
I'm gonna knock him down a peg or two.
Fires right on his dead center chest. He gurgles on his blood and collapses to the ground. The villager kind of looks around, and the skeleton looks to see if they can find anyone. All right, I need initiative for everyone, please.
13.
11.
Just 13. Wasted a natural 20. 23.
20.
All right, Almagor, what would you like to do?
All right, what one of these creepy things is closest to me? Like one of the skeletons, probably?
Well, there's a couple of shambling villagers down the road towards the center of town. You guys have to run. You're both, like I said, about 300 feet away from where Jordan is right now, so you guys are going to have to run down there. So you can run past these things, or you can try to hack them down your way.
These shambling things are pretty nasty to begin with, if I remember correctly. I'm just going to just kind of run, try to run straight to the center of town there.
Okay.
Where I just saw the guy collapse.
Okay. You snarks. SMS.
Crap. So, what is nearest to me currently? Like, if I turn around and ran, is there anything currently behind me? Or is it all kind of in front of me?
All the enemies are in front of you. Well, it depends where you want to run. Do you want to run back to the alley, like in the buildings?
Yes. That would be my bad. Okay, I will reload and fire at one of the skeletons. I missed, so then I will dash, which gives me twice my speed, and run back towards the group.
Alright, you run back towards the group quite quickly. You're closing the gap between you and Alvar. Okay, fine, which is good.
I'm gonna charge in with Almagor there. While yelling, "Aha! Fiends! You have tasted justice this day! Now you shall all fall before my blade!" Well, it's not really my blade, it's kind of a loner, but that's alright, you're all going to die!
Are you running past the other villagers shambling around, or are you gonna try and hack them down?
I'll try and hack them down. 12.
Oh yeah, that's it.
Four damage.
Right, you slice at one of these things, do four damage, opening a wound that does not bleed. It kind of just looks and stares at you, and gives you this.
Keep running past if I can.
It's Mabel. I'm sorry, dude.
So they're running straight ahead? Through the village? Is that it?
Or that is currently what's happening to the others, yes.
What? If I was to go left or right, like not go straight ahead, what am I looking at for odds of what I'm seeing? Like, is there more buildings to one side? Is there more forest to the other? Like, what?
It seems pretty evenly distributed. The buildings on either side of the road both have a couple alleyways you could sneak down potentially. But yes, buildings in both cases.
I don't like this. I'm just gonna look at Alias and be like, "There's one in there." And my eyes just kind of glaze over as I use my bonus action to go into a rage, as I just jump down into the cellar and I'm gonna go kill that thing that's in our way.
Alright, you run down to the cellar, you bust open the door, there's an unhappy looking undead villager thing staring at you. As you bust down the door, you can go ahead and take a swing at it.
21 to hit.
Oh yeah, it's a hit.
For 6 damage.
Alright, you just smack this thing, leaving a large gaping wound. Again, it's not the... It's kind of
white glazed eyes stare at you as it lets out a... Okay. Elias, what should I do?
Knowing where that door comes up in that building, do I think if I, like, went around the front and kicked in the door, I'd see this thing? Or is it a pretty big building? It's...
No, you could probably go through the front door.
Pretty immediate there. Cool. That's what I will do.
Okay. Yeah, you run around, get the front door. It's not open. Open up.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Quite aggressively.
So open it on up, and yes, sure enough, you see this shambling creature fighting Maple, facing. It's backwards you right now, so you can go ahead and attack.
Cool, and I'm gonna use both of my weapons on that one. 13.
Yes.
Yeah, on my short sword. Cool. 7 damage on that one.
Okay.
3 with my dirk. Yeah. Sorry, 5. 5. I can't
time. Okay, no, that is a miss. So the two sham things that you, or one of which you had smacked, they're by, they slowly trail after you guys, but they're quite slow, so they do not catch up to attack. You see 4 skeletons turning down the road. Now that they see you guys rushing in there, and they struck down a bit quicker, but they did not make it to you either. The creature in the building fighting Maple, yes, and it will succeed as it just swings its arm like a club and kind of hits you in the side of the head for 5 points of damage.
Okay.
And it just goes...
So oh, you can is see that half?
Antimaeus running toward... yeah, it would be half to his bludgeoning damage. But you're still running down the road towards the center of the town, I assume, right?
Yeah.
So there are 6 skeletons making their way down that road, kind of in a big group. You could meet them and start swinging at them right now if you'd like, or you can wait for what you'd like to
do. Oh, Antimaeus is still coming. Perfect.
Yeah, Antimaeus is still theoretically heading back to you. He's probably in an alley right now, but yes, he's heading through right now.
That's a lot of skeletons to take on of myself.
Oh, I'm right behind you.
Oh, that's right.
Yes. Yes. Pi is right behind you.
Ha ha
ha! Oh, right. Well, let's try this new little skill I've recently developed. I'll go into a frenzy rage.
Woo!
And attack skeletons.
Okay. I don't know what that does for you, so you'll have to let me know.
That
sounds awesome.
Basically, I get an extra melee attack as a bonus action. And I can do that with my regular rage. So it lasts for the 1 minute, but afterwards I suffer 1 level of exhaustion.
Okay.
So then after this minute, I'll be basically disadvantaged on ability checks.
Okay, cool.
So, cool. Oh. 14.
That is a hit.
Oh, phew. Okay. So 14 damage.
Okay. This thing just explodes on your weapon as you strike and shatter the ground.
Wow. Alright, well I guess I'll use my bonus action and swing at the next guy.
And you just worry that there was
a 21. And 14 more damage again.
Alright, another one bursts under the weight of your men. Bones and armor just collapse to the ground. Yes. So you're in the alleyway running right back right now. You can see where Almagar is. You can see the Age of Skeletons. You can see the pies right behind him. Maple and Alien.
If I do the math of that, there was a few skeletons coming down the road. There wasn't that many in the center of town to begin with, right? So.
Well, there were the 4. There was the 2 that were behind the guy.
Okay, so I'm assuming they're following me somewhere. So I will reload my crossbow and then use my bonus action to double dash. So if I like shot and then running back, I'm gonna try to do like a loop except around the building. So if I can get into the main area to see back where I originally shot. Can I see what the guy's doing?
Yes, definitely. I take it and run back.
Yeah, so originally I shot the guy and then I ran, and then I'm just gonna kinda loop around that house or building back so I can see back where I originally shot. And then I'll wait to see if I want to shoot at someone depending on what I see.
You see the guy in the black sun still less than this square. The villager has really taken off somewhere. He is no longer on his knees there. So otherwise the area is pretty clean. The six skeletons on the stack there must be the ones that ran down the road because they are not anywhere past the door anywhere in that area.
Okay, I'll take a shot at one of the skeletons near Almagar.
Okay.
The lows are through chest, has to go off himself. Okay, good.
There are three skeletons left.
We're gonna charge in and attack the closest one.
Good. 24 from me. 21 from JoJo.
Nice, definitely as well.
17 in total.
Okay. So JoJo bites it, holds it in place, scratches it, just comes down and blows it apart.
Ha! Barry thrust, dodge!
Okay, Maple, you're fighting this thing.
Gonna continue fighting this thing and hopefully kill it.
Sounds good to me.
Does 13 hit? Oh wait, do I get advantage? Oh okay, never mind then. I was gonna say, do I get advantage because he's being flanked?
Yes, you do, but
it hits. It hits, yeah.
You can still roll the secret.
Oh yeah, and I didn't add my 2 to, because I'm raging. I keep forgetting that. Nah, I don't crit, but that rolls way better. But, so I hit. For 9 damage.
Alright, straight through his soul bone, burns through his face, and your weapon continues on down. How you manage to do this with spear, that's questionable, but you managed nonetheless. Yeah.
That thing is just about two.
And with that, I'll play move action, and I just run out. I just, like, push Alias out of the way, I just keep going.
Mabel rushes past Alias, you get out into the road there. You can see there's a new skeleton, or two skeletons sort of still fighting Kai and Almagar, along with a couple shambling villagers that are trailing up behind. As well as just a couple more come out of a couple of the nearby alleys. So there are now 4 of these enchanted villagers walking towards the fight.
I will regain my balance, I'm assuming, and I'll follow suit and just kind of rush out into the alley to meet the rest of the gang.
Okay. You do have an opportunity to get out there and attack something if you'd like. There are 4 shambling villagers and 2 skeletons. If you want to attack.
How close are the shambling villagers to
closer than the skeletons?
I will attack whichever one I encounter first. One's in the rear.
Okay, there's one that looks like it has one large slash across it.
That's the one you're looking for.
Cool. Yeah, I like that one. That one sounds fun.
Wow, fantastic. Alright, that's a 6.
I'm gonna hurt sword. And that's a little bit better. That one is a 20 with my dirk.
Yep. The dirk.
I'll do 4 damage.
Alright, just stab your dirk into it. pull it out, normally where most people gush blood, it doesn't. It just looks, turns and looks at you with these blank eyes. And some ants, you're the first to see this, seeing as you're closest to the center of town. But out of one of the alleys across the center of town, kind of in the far diagonal, a man in a black robe who's running through sees his buddy on the ground, has clearly heard some of his consumption. And he looks behind him and yells some kind of strange word out. And from down that area, everyone hears this. And you see instantly these three large skeletal creatures with horns come billowing out of the alleyway, holding these massive two-handed axes.
Oh, yeah!
They're probably at least 9.5 feet tall.
Now we're talking!
They are just looking straight down that road, and he points a finger, and he says a few words, and these things just start billowing towards you guys. Clearly even carrying enough weight to kind of make the ground shake.
Yeah!
Shamblers. One is gonna go for you. It grabs your shoulder and it attempts to sustain its teeth into you and it manages to splash off your shoulder.
10?
Jesus. Awesome. You hear some of like the muscle that's really
interesting. Just like tearing away.
The other one that was on towards high is going to do so, does not hit. The other two that have come out the side alleys, one is going to go for Maple, the other one is going to go for Eleanor. The one after Maple does not hit. The one after Eleanor does not hit. Two skeletons that are in the Elmgar and Pi go for each. They're a huge threat, blowing to pieces. The first on Elmgar will not hit. The other one on Pi will also miss. Okay. Meanwhile, these big skeleton creatures are rushing down through the center square.
If I try to run away, the skeletons are going to attack with opportunity, right?
Disengage!
Yeah, well, I think I've got bigger targets right now I need to
You could disengage and run through them.
I need to get at these big guys.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Like
run on through
those guys.
You want the big guys?
Got bigger skeletons to fry.
Okay. Alright, so that's what you do. Push on through and keep going. Okay, Antimaeus, what would you like to do?
So these things are on the other side of the town square, so to speak, at yep. First. The man that came out as well, is he over there and just kind of pointed in that direction? Or is he near his buddy?
No, he's not at his buddy yet. He's falling behind us.
Okay. I would like to stealth and get into cover and just move back to where I originally shot from, and then I'll stealth there and wait for him to get closer.
Okay.
A 24.
Hi, what did you do? Two skeletons in front of you, kind of two zombies behind.
Jojo and I will take separate enemies, so he'll fight one skeleton, I'll fight the other. 16 from me, and Jojo misses. 6 damage for me.
Weapon hits the ribcage of the skeleton, you hear several cracks, several bones break. It still stands, but not. Okay. Maple, you're frothing at the mouth. what would you like to do? There's a creature trying to attack you right now. There's also a couple others in the vicinity, though.
Yeah, where are those big guys?
Yeah, they are in the center where it's down the street without the guard to go after them.
Yeah, I'm going to run after them as fast as I can, so I'm using my double movement. All of a sudden, Maple's just rushing up next to you there. Also awesome. frothing at the mouth.
You were both just like, I'm just frenzied out of my mind, bro.
How can you turn related?
The zombie that you were fighting with tries to grasp you, but it's too slow.
I've been trying to save my life.
Are you feeling pretty injured at the moment?
It sounds like it, yeah. Yeah, one of my shoulders is not doing so well, so I'll probably just get one weapon off.
I would imagine.
Can I?
Oh, yeah, two off.
Okay, cool.
You've been in a tight situation with a broken arm, just don't want to just stab stuff.
Perfect, alright. So I will go 17 on my short sword.
Yeah.
Cool. And I'll hit it for 5. My dirk, 15.
Yep, that's it.
For another 4.
Alright, you're thrusting in this thing. On the last hit, you kind of open up its stomach. Its guts start pouring out. It's still trying to eat you. But, it's balanced.
Do I see my chunk of shoulder?
Why would it fit?
Alright. Its response is to try and chew into your shoulder more. Oh man, you're just not very lucky with this thing. I'm sorry. It continues to crunch away at the muscle. Only for 3 points of damage this time though. The one that Maple has pushed away from kind of turns its attention to you as it realizes it can't grasp her. It moves to attack you and misses.
Thank
you're God. Not making a mistake about it. Two zombies bite your arm. Alright. One,
two, try and bite you. You are too quick for it, so it does not succeed. The other, your dog was a good tasty morsel, so he is going to try and dog.
Jojo Perry!
And this is the one that was on Almagar previously. And yes, Jojo is picking up as well to get out of the way of this little zombie. The two skeletons will now take their opportunity to fight back here.
Hi.
So misses.
Aha! Dodge Perry thrust!
Left, right, center. Weapons flashing, mashing, and
you're just... I figured you'd handle them.
Got an adrenaline rush right now.
Alright, the 3 large skeletal creatures come rushing down to meet the 2 barbarians, swinging weapons that are probably just about as tall as their heads.
Go for the knees!
Maple, 2 are coming after you.
Oh, right.
For both.
Remember, you're raging. You're resistant to a lot of things, Alvagar.
That's actually a very good point. This will be slashing damage. Or piercing in this case, sorry. They're charging at you with their weapons pointed at you. They're essentially trying to gore you at the moment.
Oh, good. At least I have some resistance.
Alvagar, you take 24 points of damage.
Oh!
This thing rushes at you.
Oh!
Base of its axe into your stomach. I mean, it doesn't pierce, but it gives you a big shove, and you feel bones and stuff raise. This is bludgeoning damage, piercing damage, my apologies. So you are resistant to it, so you cut that in half.
Okay.
And
I thought the 25 was half.
Yes.
I'm not going to cut the numbers for you guys. No. One swing? Oh my god.
It's like, yay, we just made it to level 3, and we're dead.
And dead.
Oh boy, yeah.
Maple, both of these things. Oh, sorry, what'd you get your strength? Save, by the way, there's not.
Oh, I made one roll a strength saving throw.
Oh, strength. 18.
You're raging. You get a bonus to that. You're raging. 20. You get advantage.
20. Oh, yeah, an advantage. So I'd assume I did pretty good.
Yeah, you're fine with that. It's a big blow. You feel like bones break and stuff. You're just standing strong.
You're just frenzied. You don't even feel it. That's like a tomorrow thing.
Building over. Okay. The other one strikes you right in the gut, Maple, for 24 points of damage. Again, I'm not losing, so. The other takes advantage of the first blow and strikes you in the same way, but right in the cheek. You can feel some kind of bone fracture face, and you take 30 points of damage from the strike.
Shit.
I need two strength checks from you, or strength saving throws, please. Facial standing.
I am. I don't look very good, but I am still standing. So first one is 26 for my first one, Alex, and 24.
Two crush lows, you still hold your ground, not even giving up a foot.
I should hope so, I mean, when you're raging like that. And she's just raging, I'm in a frenzy. I make her look like she's taking a walk in the park.
Antimaeus, you notice the guy in the black robe approaching behind the skeletons with a and long short sword. He looks like he's...
Alex and his crooked swords. You know they're evil when...
notice you. They got a crooked sword. Bad guys.
But he has a facey book, too.
It's more distance from bottom to top if they're crooked with the same amount of metal, so the wound they open is larger and it causes you to bleed out faster. So, yes, he does not get a chance to do anything, but he looks like he's sitting around, does not notice you at all. Almagar, what would you like to do?
Sir, I just said to kill a mockingbird. It's mocking you. That's what Almagar would do if a bard was mocking. Yeah, I'm just gonna go for this guy's knee, and if I can, knock him over at least. 17.
That is a...
Oh! I wasn't sure, these guys are pretty big. 5 damage.
Like my...
With my d12, I do 5 damage. At least you can't crit fail with damage.
But did you add your +2? You get extra damage because you're raging.
Shit.
Okay, it is.
Yeah. 14.
Did you hit it with the second one?
Yeah. Oh, jeez.
Still.
Oh, a little bit better. 13 damage. Right to the knee.
Alright, yeah, you destroy some bones, the thing still stands, and glimmers at you with glowing green eyes, and it's kind of situated within its skull. But yeah, you break out your bones, it doesn't look like this. Alright,
so, we've got Maple and Almagar side by side fighting 3 large skeletons in front of them. The sneaky man is behind those skeletons, or to the side of Almagar or Maple?
He's now at the side of the skeletons with the intent of trying to sneak around to various barbarians, essentially.
Oh, shit.
How far away is he from me right now?
He's within 30 feet.
I will take a shot at him, I guess.
Okay.
And that's just 20.
It's definitely a hit.
And then I don't have advantage or surprise, though, right?
You can take surprise because he has no idea.
Are you sure? Because that makes it a natural for Nathan.
Yeah, he's so focused on killing the barbarians.
Yeah, he's black. I don't know, I'm gonna kill these great. That's 25 damage.
Oh yeah, you peg the guy right in the chest. This is the last one. It's like there's someone's big bullseye to you. And he just can...
I will, I'll attempt to hide.
Alright.
Okay. I'll move. Like, I want to stand there, I'll move across the alley or something and try to hide again.
Just sneak over up that crooked sword.
Yeah.
Get in, I'll go back to the shadows.
Hi. There's two skeletons in front of you, one's almost goner, and two zombies behind you.
I'm gonna tell Jojo to disengage and tell him to go help the barbarians.
Rush off against the barbarians.
And once he's gone, I'm going to just let out a big war cry. And out of instinct, I'm going to slam the hilt of my sword into my shield. And everything within 15 okay. feet of me has to make a Constitution 11.
Awesome. All right.
Wow. That's pretty intimidating.
All right. So all four of the zombies fail. And so do the two skeletons. So what happens when they fail that that con check?
They all take 10 damage and get pushed 10 feet away from me.
What? Holy shit.
So when I slam my hilt, my blade into my shield, this huge wave of thunder just explodes out of me.
Alright, were you expecting that?
No, it was totally out of instinct.
Alright, so just like this taunting call, and all of a sudden, something happens, and the shockwave just bursts from my fingers.
Remind me to burn at the stake next time.
Two skeletons burst apart. The zombie that's eating your arm, its head's detached from its shoulders.
That was
crazy. A chunk of its stomach flies out towards you and just splats all over you. It's still alive, but it has a big hole in its side.
Perfect.
And to more effect that the two zombies behind you, I explode various ways on you. They're still alive, but just chunks of them are missing.
I don't know if this matters, but about right. it's audible for about 300 feet from wherever it was used, just so you know.
Alright, so all of you guys here like this.
Right. I will get clobbered, so a little preoccupied, but I certainly not expect to see your army or something come after me.
Look, more drums! Oh my god!
More magics!
Alright, Maple.
I am going to attack the giant skeleton that hit me.
The one that hit me in the face, not hit me in the stomach.
Oh, yeah, no, the one that hit me in the face.
Alright.
23 to hit.
That is definitely a hit.
Now don't roll a 1 for damage like me.
For 11 damage.
Great.
And out of curiosity, how big are these, like, guys? Like, would they be classified as, like, a large creature?
They would, yeah.
Well, that's my turn.
Okay. Break some bones if you're snapping, the thing growls at you.
Now it's bad. It'll be doing more than 30 damage.
It's not enough. Alright, Alias, so what would you like to do? One hand load up. Zombies in front of you.
Skeletons in front of the barbarians.
I'm gonna try and take out the other half of the blown apart chunk. And 14.
It's a short sword. Cool.
Awesome. 4 damage.
So you hack it. All the way to the dead.
And 10 with my dirk. And I'll do 6 damage with that guy.
Alright. You manage with the dirk to cut the rest way down. It flaps in on the bottom and just walks to the other side, falling apart. Entrails everywhere. Would you like to do any movement? The battlefield right now looks like there's Pi staying there. Something just happened with him banging and showed the big shockwave. He's supposed to be very injured zombies in front of him.
Just
a large skeleton.
How close am I to Pi?
Ish. You're within my 10.
Okay. You know what? I'll probably
hold there
and prepare my bow.
Alright, by the two only half-living zombies are coming at you. One man just long ass exposed skin.
They took 5 points of damage. The other is too slow, you're out of the way. Perhaps the first one got a little advantage on you, but not, it didn't actually get advantage.
But had some opportunity to attack because you're so shocked and disbelieved from what just happened. Almagar won't attack you. Swings and barely misses with a two-handed great axe swiping down, crashes into the muddy ground beside you. Well, probably would have split you in two for the hit. Alright. Other one.
Dexterous.
One swings, you're quick enough to duck. Unfortunately, the other swing does collide with you for 19 points of damage.
19? That's not half? Okay. It's because I am in a rage!
Alright, yeah! Okay, so yeah, you were quick enough again to dodge one, but with the wounds you currently have, you're probably sluggish on the second dodge, and great axe came to chunk out of your chest just to make one answer flow.
Just glancing.
Yeah, that's about, you get a big drag down your chest here.
Gotta be careful about it being a titless freak. No. Oh my goodness.
Just remember who's fighting two of these guys right now. What are you doing?
Alright, Almagar. Take an attack.
Okay, I'll be attacking the same knee, same spot.
Okay.
And get this guy to fall down at least. 15. 13 damage is my bonus attack. Since he's still standing. No.
He is, yeah. More bones breaking and shattering, but not much.
10. I don't think that hits.
It does not. Alright, so in a frenzy of combat with this thing, watching several swings of its axe as you're trying to get blow in, you do strike the knee once. And the other top end is just a little bit quick. Alright, Antimaeus, what do you want to do?
Do I see anyone else coming from the courtyard area?
You do not.
And they're about 30 feet away from me. I guess I'll just take a shot at the nearest one to me. So that's 12 damage.
Alright. Are you factoring in surprise with this?
No.
Gonna do so on this one only. They'll know of your presence after this, but because they are somewhat mindless, the killing of the other man is not explosive.
Well, I rolled straight ones, so that's an additional 3 damage. Well, so 15 in total.
Okay. Alright, so you Mabel sticks into one of the bones of the one that Mabel has done some damage against as well, and still stands.
Alright, and I move 15 feet closer to it.
Hi, what would you like to do? 2 injured zombies behind, 3 large skeletons ahead.
How far are these giant skeletons?
They would take a full turn to run over there. They're about just over 60 feet away. Jojo is there, however, now, so if you'd like to make an attack with him, you can definitely do so.
Yeah, I'm going to disengage these guys and head over there. Jojo will attack, though.
Okay.
He'll attack the one that's attacking Maple.
There's two of them attacking.
The injured one or the full health one?
The injured one.
How much damage a dog could do to a skeleton?
Will he be able to knock him prone? How big is this
likely
thing?
Not a large creature. Oh, okay. I'll still roll against it to be sure, but yeah, they'll be getting some assistance constantly.
Natural 20.
Nice. All right. JoJo finds a way. Not.
Well, I rolled 3 ones, so 3 damage.
Wait, are you your bonuses?
That is the bonus.
Oh.
All right.
What bonuses?
Sorry, was it on the one that Maple had already injured?
Yeah.
Also, those big skills.
JoJo runs up. Bites on his leg. Like, kind of withdraws. All right. And the zombies slowly follow behind you. Okay. Your springboard skeletons. Maple, what would you like to do? Rain down some destruction, I hope.
Since don't let the dog make you look bad.
Do I get advantage on the one that's being attacked, the one that I've been attacking?
JoJo's there, so.
Yes.
Awesome. 20 to hit?
That definitely a hit.
Okay. For 8 damage. And then I'd like to try and move a little bit more around him, so I'm slightly trying to get away from the guy, the other one that's full health attacking me.
So you strike it with your spear, whole bones crack and shatter again, still stands, and then you try and parry this guy a little bit to keep the attention of the other one. Okay, Ilias, what would you like to do? Got your bow out. There are two zombies falling pile in, and then a green dark skeleton.
I'm gonna try and help with one of those skeletons. Yeah, the zombies can kind of do their thing for a little bit.
There are some two large skeletons, have a few broken bones, shattered ribs, that sort of thing, and then one looks like it's in as good condition as it was in the beginning.
I'll go for the one that is attacking Maple that is damaged, just to see if we can try and get rid of at least one of these things.
Yeah, she is certainly looking very, very injured, so...
Yeah. So...
Definitely
bloody. Because these things are 9 feet tall, I'm gonna make a significant effort to, like, not shoot straight into my allies. And, like...
aim up.
Just to clarify.
A long shot comes straight down somebody's skull.
There's an album of the arrow sticking straight in his butt.
You're like, Maple! And I'll be like, wasn't me!
Yeah, I'll be bleeding. Maple! I get my head hurt.
13.
Sweet. 7 damage on that guy.
16 points of damage. Not half. So he does strike you, take a little wind out of you, but I assume he'll still stand. The winter one, they're Maple. He continues. He's just way too much in a frenzy of a battle here with you to stop, so he will continue to attack. 20 points of damage.
And I'm unconscious.
Alright, so the axe comes down, buries itself deep into his shoulder. He withdraws, everyone sees Maple fall to the ground, unconscious.
With 10 points of damage.
Surrounds her. Okay, the other one. What does it want to do?
That guy hiding in the shadows.
Yeah, unfortunately not far from the truth, they're Antimaeus. You're the only other guy standing aside from a dog. The skeleton approaches you. Antimaeus will take a hefty swing, and it will land. Apparently you're very quick as it lands its weakest blow so far for 10 points of damage. A swing, more endurance taken out of you to out of the way of this hefty axe than anything else. Okay, that is them. Almagar. Maple struck down beside you. Let it fuel your rage!
I'm starting to sound like the octopus thing down in the 16. Yes! Finally some real damage. 16 damage.
Nice. Alright, you break apart several of the bones in its leg. It's now limping along. This thing is getting much closer to being a pile of bones in the ground. Its green eyes still kind of stare lifelessly back at you, but you are feeling that it's probably not far.
Good, well, let's see if I can. I'll use my bonus action and. 21? Gosh. Yes! What was that damage? 16 last time, right?
Yep,
16 again, yeah. Rolled 11 twice now.
Alright, you find that weakness in the bone. Strike it once, it shatters, you strike it again, clean through, the thing comes collapsing down the ground, the force of its own weight strikes the ground, crushes its ribcage, and it becomes as the skull rolls away from its skeletal neck, the green eyes fade out, and it just becomes a pile of bones.
Oh, glad it
didn't
land on me.
Yeah,
all tangled up in his ribcage.
Meanwhile, two death saves now, and I'm like,
right, yes, miss. What you do, big skeleton man trying to smack you apart.
Use disengage, yep. And then I will double move back into the main alley, 60 feet away.
Hi, what would you like to do?
Then blur, and then he quickly just leaves again.
Yeah, I mean, me and Jojo are going to attack the last standing giant skeleton there. And I miss. Unless 11 hits.
Yeah. Oh, sorry.
19 for Jojo.
Definitely.
4 damage from him.
Gives this thing another gnaw, and a pull breaks a bone right from this thing's leg. Still standing. It's...
Actually, I'm going to action surge and attack again. That's better. 18 to hit.
Yep.
5 damage.
You break another piece of its rib from the cage. This thing is also looking like very nice. Okay, Maple. Death save, please.
So what do I roll?
Roll a d20. If it is 10 or lower, it's a failure. 11 or higher is success.
10 or lower is a failure.
Okay, so one failure. Yeah, yes.
There's still two of these things?
Yes. One is very injured, one is
not injured.
Yeah.
Cool. I'll go for the injured one.
Okay.
With my bow. That is a 20 for 5 damage.
Okay. Arrow plunges into its skull, you see that it's cracked from its skull, one of its horns falls off and drops to the ground. Its eyes kind of look down the road.
Look wanderingly down.
Like that too much.
Step on the zombies!
Okay, it lets out a near-death battle cry of... And it's gonna try and charge you, looking like it's gonna try and gore you as it did the others. However, Almagar and Pi and Jojo can all take attacks of opportunity on it as it does. Come on, guys.
12
is a hit.
Oh,
12 is the bare minimum. You can get on this thing.
16! 11 for the road.
Should be rolling on a d12.
Yeah. 17 and 21. And
nice.
8 damage in total.
Nice. Alright. So this thing just like tries to push by Almagar and Pi, charging directly towards Ilias. Jojo grabs him at its ankle, like gets caught up. Almagar hacks it from behind the knee. It's
double edge, and then Pies finishes it off by thrusting the sword back as small as it collapses with me.
Yeah.
The thing just falls apart and crumbles into a pile of bones yet again.
Top of some of the zombies?
Way over. They're getting close to this point, but they're still like,
dude.
Which this guy. Really, this guy. What a wise guy.
Okay. The one that is...
I like how you think. You're gonna stay. I'm gonna make a fuck here.
It's not gonna phalanx down that alley. Instead, just turns, swinging its axe towards you, Pythagoras.
Is this the giant skeleton?
Yeah, the last one. For 12 points of damage, it comes across, swings. That's more endurance, can't do anything, just get out of the way. Two zombies are within striking range for their next attacking round here as a heads up, so they're pretty close. Alright, Almagar, what would you like to do? One of these big guys left, or two zombies?
Oh, big one for the big guy. 16... 8 damage. Oh, right, and the bonus attack. Man.
And the bonus attack.
That comes in handy.
What a bonus.
12.
Alright. They just don't prevail.
And 9 damage.
9 miss. The thing is no longer following you. You're in the alleyway.
And can I see it, or did I move out of it? Oh. And does it look like it's getting chopped to pieces, or is it still pretty solid?
Still pretty solid. Bone shards flying away, but yeah, it still stands strong.
But it's got a couple people engaged with it?
Yeah, it is.
Okay, I will do an awesome epic dash back towards it.
He's pulling Alvagar.
Yep, pretty much.
Run away, Tom,
and then I will... get up behind it and try to stab it.
Alright.
Okay, so 22 to hit.
Yep.
For 13 damage.
Awesome. A large bone snaps as you strike it. The thing kind of wavering out wildly with its axe. Pipe.
Well, at least people are attacking it and getting it distracted. I'm going to use a healer kit on Maple.
Okay.
So you're at 1.
Alright, so you can go ahead and do that. If they're stabilized, you get the points back. That's a little bit easy there.
I'm going to use second wind to get some of my hit points back, too.
Okay.
God damn it. Fucking ones.
So sorry. Alright, so Maple, you're obviously no longer making death saves. You awake, you are no longer enraged, but alive, at least. So what would you like to do?
This is not a good time to be sleeping, Maple. Not a good time for that.
Yeah, looking around, two of the skeletal structures have collapsed, but your comrades are not looking like they're doing so well.
I got this.
I am... going to put away my spear and pull out my crossbow. I also want to move away from the giant skeleton, but I want to shoot one of the zombies that are approaching.
Okay.
And I miss.
Okay. Well, flies wild. They have a very low to hit. Are you sure you missed?
I rolled 3, so 3 plus 3, 6, 7, 8. 8 hit?
8 is a hit.
Oh. Wow. Oh, wow. Okay, well, didn't see that coming.
Please don't take much.
I forgot to attack with JoJo.
Oh, you can go ahead and do that, sorry. I kind of skipped over it.
Oh, that's a G8. Okay.
Hey, misses.
Okay.
For 5 damage.
Fireball. Punk.
right in the head of one of these things. It just collapses over as his eyes roll back to its head.
I'm gonna set down the next skill.
You're not back yet.
Arrow flies by, still not.
And then I was like, oh no, that's gonna
eat something. This thing go call a meat shield for another.
this thing swings again at you, Pi, trying to take you out. It will miss barely, but it's the zombie that's still living, that's trailing you, also makes an attempt, but bites air. Okay, Almagar.
Okay.
You.
Let's finish this guy off. 13, okay, good. Wow, I like this die. 4 11s now, no joke.
Nice.
So 16.
Awesome. Hit it up above your head, you shatter its sternum. Several of the ribs fall from it. This thing just goes into a frenzy, swinging its axe around. It stands, but barely, guys. This is the moment.
Okay.
That's what you're going to do.
Can I do one more?
Oh, sorry, you stole an attack. My bad. I'm sorry. I keep forgetting that.
Ooh. Oh, okay, that's definitely hit. Okay, not 11, but let's see. 7.
Okay, another shoot sternum, ribs all cracked, it looks good. Evil green eyes, Antimaeus. Let's do.
I will swing at it and try to kill it. And make you roll a net 20, so.
Nice.
that should do it.
Just
I did it all great.
It's injured, now it's a killing blow! He comes in.
It takes the attention off of me.
24 damage.
Holy what? Shit. That's. Oh, come on. I couldn't do that much damage if I tried.
Wait, you did crit. You got that 20.
Okay,
I'm
like.
You're right behind me, too. So.
You're making the barbarian look like. Scary.
Hey, man, you consistently threw 16s there for a while. That's not.
Yeah,
that's
true.
Alright, with that. Are you attacking Ruby?
Yeah, a short sword, yeah.
Okay. You plunge it into its lower kind of spine from where you are right now. It breaks a large vertebrae right there. The top collapses right back up over the bottom half. The head rolls to the ground. And as the eyes go out, so does the life from the shambling zombie behind you guys. It also collapses into a pile of flesh. It is quiet.
Holy shit.
And that is where we will leave it for tonight.